Doom 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 doom. Super Mario Maker. This is a hacker's daydream here. Now, people who aren't familiar with hacking of old games may not be aware that there are people who made custom Mario games that were either silly, absolutely fucking batshit hard, or even music stages that play themselves while playing music. That was a thing happening on the internet. There was all kinds of ROM hacks, and this is clearly Nintendo's capitalizing on that market. And I think they do a real good job of making it different too. Because while in those cases you mainly have only access to the assets of the game they're hacking, there's a lot of other things. Like fucking Sonic's in this. Sonic is in this. Link is in this. Samus is in this. So they add a lot of additional little flavor, not just simply only using Mario in that. Sadly, a lot of those characters are through amiibo support, which does suck. This is probably one of the newest games that make massive use of like almost all of the fucking amiibos, almost, if not all of them. I mean, it uses a lot of them, but it does focus a lot on the Mario stuff in that. Now they did a nice style idea where basically you can go with Classic 3, Super Mario World, or Wii U. So you have four different designs you can go with. And it'll use those kind of play styles, like in Wii U and Super Mario. Mario can do his little spin jump thing, but he can't do that in the older ones. So it sticks to their play style in the titles, and their power-ups and things are changed if you change the style. Now they did actually like we add a few enemies into older versions in that to balance it out. Like for example, Bowser Jr. He has a version of himself in the other three styles, even though he never existed in those styles. So a few enemies have been reworked into a few of the styles, but overall it uses a lot of pure things, and it gives you a lot of creative freedom. I've seen a lot of crazy stages. I've played a good amount of the game too. And it's just crazy all the shit you can do. Like people have literally been doing exactly the same thing people do with ROM hacks, you making play stages that play themselves, fucking music that plays itself, crazy stages, simple stages, bat shit ridiculously fucking hard as nails, fucking ass stages. Now when you start the game, it gives you a little stage and you kind of get to mess around and make the stage is a little tutorial and that, and you start out in the course making, and then from that you can go into the Mario 10 mode, which as far as I can tell are stages in the game itself, and then 100 man mode, which is doing people's online stages, and then you can also look up based on ranking of course stages or by popularity of the people making the stages. So it's very simple access to all these things through a menu. You can get the pop-up on the right side, so you can quickly go from course or any of the Mario fighting challenges, or just look up courses and that. You can also share the courses. When you upload them, it'll give a ID number that people can look up so they can directly download it and such, or play and, you know, stuff like that. Now, interesting, and this is a very good design, one of my initial thoughts with the game was how are they going to really stop people from making like an impossible stage? And they actually did that very simply. You have to beat the stage first before it can be uploaded, which is maniacally evil at the same time, because if you want to make a really hard stage for people to do, and you know for a fact why making it's possible, you still have to beat it. So I hope you're just as skilled as the crazy, sick, horrible things you make in the game, because that's the only way other people are gonna play them. But overall, I mean, there ain't a whole lot to talk about here if you're familiar with this kind of stuff here. I mean, there's a lot of trollish stuff you can do in the game, and it's just crazy. And there is a lot of added flair. There's sound effects and some unique sprite stuff, some fireworks and sound effects and cheers and, like, there's this weird punching thing there. I haven't quite unlocked all the things yet. But, originally the game was going to launch, well, over 9 days, as long as you played 5 minutes of Course Maker, you would unlock each set of things, but they made it instead, well, if you just basically messed around so long in the Maker mode and all the new stuff you unlocked, you could basically essentially unlock everything in 1 day, so you can get access to everything really quick, and it is just, it is really fun. If you love collating stuff, this is a great game. If you're looking to play people's stuff, it's a good game. You essentially get all the endless Mario levels you could possibly want with this handmade by tons of people. There's a lot of content here, simply from either creating or just playing things that people created. With the ranking and waiting system, that you can always get a lot of different content. Now, at the time of this, I do have to throw out though the highest ranked stages. A lot of them are the stage plays themselves styles. They're either music or just crazy flashy stages that play themselves. And while I can understand that liking, you know, that takes a lot of time to make those, you know, if you're looking for just a really good stage, you know, in like the top 20 slots or just stages that play themselves, it seems kind of limiting how many are listed at a time. Like, there's no more deeper search mechanic without the exact ID number of a shared stage. And then, on looking at the creators, they only list the top 50, and you can't look beyond that. So, whoever the top 50 followed, liked, favorite, all that crap, are going to be the ones in those 50 slots, so you can't look up other people. Now, there is a tab when you're looking at courses that you could also look at up and coming, which are new stages uploaded, but considering how a lot of the layout is, I mean, like, this stage I put up, and I mean, you know, I don't got, like, some fantastic stage or anything, but I only had 3 people play it, and looking at I played a lot of upcoming ones on my second stream I did of the game, and a lot of them just get 1 or 2 people in there, and it doesn't look like a lot of people check out new people. They just kind of stick to the high-weighted in the 50 cradles, who, for the most part, are, like, almost the exact same people, with a few YouTube personalities that are also in there. It's kind of limiting in looking up variety. That's probably my most criticism there, is not being able to look up a lot of different people out of the top 50. But I'm sure there will be a strong community that will continue, which is one of my fears with the top 50, that mainly the top 50 are more likely to be the top 50. There probably won't be a lot of changes between them, so, you know, that kind of kills looking for new stages. And considering stages don't stay up forever, kind of like how Bloodborne's Chalice Dungeons or temporarily on the server, your stages are temporarily on the server. Now, I'm assuming the ones that don't get played after so long are the ones that get booted, and the ones that keep getting played get to stay on, is what I would assume. Which, again, it leaves the ones that keep getting voted and everything up there, where newer, fresh talent is going to have more trouble trying to get out there. So, those are the just slight things that I have to complain about. But really, it's not a whole lot to add. I mean, you get to make Mario stages. You get to make what you want, as trollishly evil, as hard. Like, I did a stage where literally I had to jump on one flying turtle and then just keep jumping on flying turtles. And then there was another one where midway I had to jump on a bunch of flying springs that were flying by. And if I didn't jump on them in time, and they flew by, I was stuck. But it has to be made where the player can actually beat it. So it was beated. And hell, there was a very odd stage where there was a pipe that was shooting out the P-switch, a wall, and then right past the wall, there was the flagpole. And I, for the life of me, couldn't figure... Because the blocks weren't the blocks that change in the coins. They were the ground environment kind of blocks. So when I hit the P-switch, nothing happens. Just, you know, it's tomb plays. You can't go down the pipe. So I literally could not figure out what to do. My only idea I could think of is that somehow you had to kick the P-block into the wall and, like, jump off of it and do a spin jump on top of it or something. And that would have taken me millions of years to even pull off, even if that is what I was supposed to do. So there's a lot of good stages, troll stages, silly stages, joke stages. Just a large variety of everything. I'm just concerned about how much fresh new stages will be rotated in along with all the stuff that keeps getting weighted at the top. Like I said, like there was a person who did the Kirby, the Willie, I can't remember what it was called. Na 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 na. Like that had to take forever. That really had to take forever to make. There's no way I couldn't give that a store, but a lot of those are taking up the top courses. So, but. Overall, I'm really enjoying it so far. I will probably do more of it. I definitely want to do more of it. Really, it's just, I want to find more stages, though. I want to find more silly stages. I heard one guy made a funny one where you break out of prison as Peach and kick Bowser's ass. That's funny. And I remember seeing another one where a person stacked like four Bowsers on top of each other. It's like, some people are really evil. But anyway, those are my thoughts on Mario Maker. If you have any questions or anything about Mario Maker you would like me to ask me, please leave me a comment down below, and I will see you next time. Because Mario number one. Na 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 no na 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 no na 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 no no. Wave your hands from side to side. Come on, it's time to do the Mario. I couldn't help it. Oh.
Yeah! go, 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 go,